Hi, and welcome to Ivy League Analytical English. I'm Angela.
And I'm Wesley.
Today is September 27th, and we have another two-day article for you, and this one is about the history and future of Silicon Valley. Wow, an older title might have been Silicon Valley, Past and Present, or Past and Future.
那我们今天这篇文章讲的是矽谷的这个故事。 那我们中文标题是众神之谷，那谷当然就指矽谷那个谷。
And yeah, I don't think we can get all of the history and future of Silicon Valley into such a short article, but considering the influence that Silicon Valley has on every single one of our lives, it's worth studying in more detail than we can give you here.
Yeah, 好，那这个矽谷对于我们现代人的生活有很大很大的举足轻重的影响，所以了解一下这个矽谷的历史，这个是蛮值得的。
So our article, let's just jump right into reading the article because there's just a lot to talk about here. Silicon Valley has long been synonymous with innovation, technology, and business startups. Much of what makes everyday life possible for modern society is due to the tech giants of the San Francisco Bay Area, including Apple, Google, Facebook, and Microsoft. Some may argue that Silicon Valley is a mindset rather than a place, since success is not necessarily dependent on location. Either way, it would be wrong to dismiss its geographical history. After all, the technology hub did not just develop its reputation overnight. Because of San Francisco's port, the influence of the U.S. Navy allowed radio and telegraph industries to flourish and paved the way for the construction of NASA's Ames Research Center in 1939 to conduct aeronautics research. William Shockley, creator of the transistor, the building block of electronic systems, founded Shockley Semiconductor Labs in the area in the 1950s. They were the first to use silicon in semiconductors, laying the foundation for a booming industry. Journalist Don Heffler first used the name Silicon Valley in the USA in his 1971 report on the industry, and the name has stuck ever since. The Valley also owes its existence and prosperity to Stanford University. Frederick Terman, provost and dean of engineering, nurtured tech firms by leasing them land in the Stanford Industrial Park. He also encouraged graduates and faculty to start their own companies, such as William Hewlett and David Packard, who went on to create Hewlett-Packard in 1939. Today, the company is best known for their printers, computers, and more. Stanford was also one of the sites of a government research project that would later become the global phenomenon we all know as the Internet. With their impact on the Bay Area, it is little wonder that Terman and Shockley are called the fathers of Silicon Valley. So in our first paragraph, our author questions whether geographic history matters in the development of things. But then in the second two paragraphs, we basically very much like ascertained that it's because all these people were concentrated together that all this research happened. I mean, if you ask anybody now about what's still Silicon Valley today, they will tell you that the reason why you go there is that you can get anything you need up and down the corridor. You just like computer parts, anything from physical parts to advice on how to make a system happen. You can find all of the human and physical capital right there. Proximity does matter when developing new things.
Yeah,好，所以这篇文章呢，它虽然在第一段一开始就说。 有的人认为呢，这个Silicon Valley它是一个mindset啊，但其实这个地点是很重要的啊，因为这个现到一直到现在，很多因为很多高科技的东西都集中在矽谷，所以在那里做很多事情是比较方便的啊。你可能你要发展的新的电脑或者是有一个新的产品，电子产品、科技产品，你可能需要的东西在矽谷通通都找得到啊，因为那里有一个concentration啊，大集中在那边。
I mean, that's the theory why industrial parks are still encouraged for when government wants to encourage development today. You create an industrial park, put everyone together, and then development happens.
Yeah,好，那所以工业区这个概念现在还是很多人信仰的啊，还是很多人觉得很有重要性、很有道理的，因为你把相关的工业全部集中在一起啊。 甚至于不相关的工业都集中在一起，说不定这些不相关的工业就会变成相关的工业，
right?
就产生一些新的工业出来了。Yeah,
exactly. So Silicon Valley has long been synonymous with innovation, technology, and business startups. This is true. This is the main three associations with Silicon Valley.
好，所以这个矽谷呢，很久以来 has long been, 很久以来都是 synonymous with, 就是它是什么东西的同义词，也就是说你想到矽谷你就会想到这些字。所以什么字跟矽谷是同义词呢？包括创新 innovation, technology, 科技，还有呢 business startups, 一些商业的新创公司，startups 就是新创公司。
Much of what makes everyday life possible for modern society is due to the tech giants of the San Francisco Bay Area. So saying like, basically what makes everyday life possible for modern society is the internet and all the gadgets associated with it. And the tech giants that we list here in this sentence, Apple, Google, Facebook, and Microsoft, these are later, actually, companies. They're not the ones that built the infrastructure that modern society depends on. They built the cars that go on that, on those roads, basically. But the infrastructure builders, the people who created the structures that our current society is built on, are listed later on in the article.
好，所以呢，我们先看这个句，他说呢，很多使得我们现代生活成为可能的一些东西呢，所以 much 就是有很多什么东西呢？ What makes everyday life possible for modern society? 对于现代社会生活，每天生活里面成为可能的很多东西，也就是我们之所以能够享受现代的生活，每天的这种日常生活呢，有很多都是因为 is due to 因为这些 tech giants 这些科技的巨人，在这个旧金山的 Bay Area 这个地方的这些科技巨人所以包括苹果啊，好 Google 啊 ，Facebook 啊，还有这个 Microsoft 好，那这个当然 Angela 讲到说，这个事实上。这个 Bay Area 这个地方他们的 infrastructure 其实不是这些公司所奠定的它的基础不是这些奠定的但是呢这些公司呢利用当时利用这个地方所有的这个基础呢达到他们现在的重要性所以他们利用了这些基础建设还有当地的环境人才使得他们有现在这样的成就
It's much easier to point to iPhones and personal computers.It's much easier to point to objects than to what makes them run. But none of the objects that these companies make or software would mean anything if the infrastructure of the internet had not been set up first.
Yeah.
And so that's what I meant about like these guys built cars, but you had to build the roads first. And the people that build the roads is the Ames Research Center and William Shockley with the semiconductor labs and then like...You know, the U.S. government putting the money into ARPANET, which turned into the internet.
好，所以这个地方我们刚刚讲到所谓的基础建设，其实最重要一个就是网络还有电脑的这个科技那网络跟电脑科技使得这些公司现在能够这么的壮大那其他我们刚刚讲到这个网络或电脑科技的这些工程建设这些东西的工程呢，我们文章后面会提到它其实跟美国政府跟军方都有一些关系。
Now, the next sentence says, some may argue that Silicon Valley is a mindset rather than a place. And I think those people are arguing from the idea of the sort of the myth of Silicon Valley or the idea of endless innovation and creativity. Since success is not necessarily dependent on location. That's true. You can be successful anywhere. It's just your chances of success are exponentially greater when you're around a whole bunch of people doing what you're doing.
Yeah.好，所以 some may argue 有些人可能会说呢，这个矽谷只是一个 mindset 一种这个思考模式，一种这个心态。好 ，mindset 它基本上是一种 mental attitude 然后呢，它会决定你的 response， 决定你的这个 interpretation of things， 好，决定你对于事情的一些看法所以他们说矽谷只是一种思维的模式，而不是一个地方我讲这种 some people 最有可能就是他不在矽谷的话，他可能就会说矽谷只是个 mindset so I don't have to be there.
I mean, there's a huge trend now of people leaving Silicon Valley to go to Texas because it's cheaper and more space in Texas. And so Texas might have, you know, like a little Silicon Valley be coming up. Although no one has used that term, by the way. I don't know what the people in Texas are calling it. But this is a thing that's happening now. Because the Bay Area is overcrowded.
Yeah. 好，那当然矽谷现在有它的问题。它现在太挤了。好，所以这个有些人可能外移了。好，像我们文章里面有提到有些人是往亚洲移了。那在美国的话，他 他们很多人跑到德州去了啊，因为那里比较便宜，土地啊、成本啊什么都这个都比较便宜啊。
And there's a lot of oil money knocking around there.
Yeah, 而且德州很有钱，有石油的钱啊。因为矽谷的房地产啊，最少我印象中好像矽谷的房地产现在也是飙得很厉害啊，这个房价非常的高。好，所以呢，他说接下来下面这句话真的，他说成功呢不一定是 is not necessarily dependent on 啊 ，dependent 就是依靠。成功不一定 ，not necessarily， 不一定要依靠 location， 不一定要依靠你的位置啊。不过这个地利之变啊，还是有它的重要性的啦。
Either way, regardless of whether it's location dependent or not location dependent, whether success is or is not location dependent, it would be wrong to dismiss its, meaning Silicon Valley's, geographical history.After all, the technology hub did not just develop its reputation overnight. It didn't just suddenly become this amazing place.
Either way, 就是不管怎么样，不管是跟它的 location 有关还是无关，还是它是个 mindset， 还是它只是个集中地，不管怎么样呢， it would be wrong. 就如果你要这样想的话，那就错了。所以各位要注意到这个地方，它是 it would be wrong， 用的是 would。啊，不是说 it will be wrong 啊，是 it would be wrong。那言下之意就是怎么样？就是如果你这样想的话 ，it would be wrong， 那就错了啊。这是假设的状态，所以它是用 would 啊。所以呢，你如果这样想就错了。怎么想呢？你如果 dismiss 啊，就是当作没看到，或者是完全这个不看啊，完全否定，完全不看它的地理的上面的历史来的话呢，那就不对了啊。所以你完全不看它的地理历史或者这一块地方它的历史的话，那就不对了。然后下一句说 ,after all, 毕竟呢 ,the technology hub, 这个 hub 在这就是指 a center of activity, 啊这个科技的中心它并不是 develop its reputation, 它的名声并不是怎么样发展而是 overnight, 它不是 overnight, 就是隔夜啊也就是很快的一朝一夕就发展出它的名声了叫做 it did not develop its reputation overnight, 啊 overnight 就是好像是一个晚上就成功了啊，或者 suddenly 的意思。
Right, like Rome wasn't built in a day.
Yeah.
It's another way to say it.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Now, because of San Francisco's port, because it's less true today, but it's still important. If a city is a port, that means there's a lot of goods coming through it. Usually navies also dock at ports. Mm-hmm. And so the San Francisco port is a major...Navy base there. And so the influence of the U.S. Navy in that area allowed radio and telegraph industries to flourish because this was just after World War I and just before World War II. And wars develop technology. This is a truism. And so the technologies of World War I and telecommunications got worked on our way to World War II, and that's what was happening here for the U.S. Navy. They needed communications, and so they needed people to help them develop radio and telegraph industries, and so they put money out for that, and so they started to attract the kind of people to develop this. And so this allowed these industries to flourish, and it paved the way, it created the possibility for the construction of NASA's Ames Research Center. So if you are a space agency,You for sure want to go to somewhere where radio and telegraph industries are being developed because then this is pre the internet. You need to be able to walk next door and talk to people or easily get to people who have the technologies you need. And so this happened that NASA put this research center there in 1939 to conduct aeronautics research. Also, you're close to the airplane industry, which is developing further up the coast.In Oregon and Washington, not in Oregon, yeah, in Washington.
Mm.
So there's a number of industries simultaneously developing along there.
I mean Washington State.
Washington State.
Okay, 好。所以呢，这个地方呢，这里讲到说这个，因为旧金山它的 port 就是 harbor 的意思，旧金山有港口，啊，所以呢，因为有港口在那边，所以美国海军啊有在那边，所以 the influence of the U.S. Navy 啊，美国海军的影响啊 allowed.使得好这个 radio 或者是这个 telegraph 啊无线电或者电报的这个工业 industries to flourish 啊在蓬勃发展，因为那里有海军基地，那海军彼此之间联系要靠 radio 要靠 telegraph 啊，所以它的这两方面的工业在旧金山就蓬勃发展，然后呢，因此而 pave the way for 什么什么什么，就是为什么铺了路啊 ，pave the way for somebody to do something。 啊，那这是一个这一个结构 pave the way for somebody to do something。这个 somebody 是什么呢？或者 something 啊？那这个 something 或 somebody 就是 the construction of NASA's Ames Research Center 啊，这个 NASA 他们的Ames 这样的一个研究中心，埃姆斯研究中心的建构，就为了他们等于说为了这个研究中心的建构铺了路啊，在1939年，然后呢去干嘛呢？去进行 to conduct to carry out 进行一些航空学方面的研究啊。Aeronautics research, 航空学的研究啊。那这个当然这个 Angela 老师也说，其实一直往北啊，一直到华盛顿州这边，其实都有很多他们重要的航空工业的这个发展的地方。好，那因为有这样子的状况，所以替这里打下了基础。
Now, William Shockley, who is the creator of the transistor, which is the building block of electronic systems,He founded Shockley Semiconductor Labs in the area in the 1950s. So we've kind of skipped the war. The war happened and technology kept a pace. And so the transistor, William Shockley invented the transistor. And we're so used to the idea of transistors that it's kind of hard to imagine how revolutionary it was at the time. A transistor is basically a tiny electronic switch, which allows you to build systems. Like computers are...based on transistors. Before, when computers were the size of the rooms, transistors were big. And after a while, somebody figured out how to make transistors into chips, and that's why computers have become smaller. But without transistors being invented, you have no ability to invent a computer. So the transistor was an amazing and intensely important step in the development of computers. And William Shockley is the dude who did it, and he built thisShockley Semiconductor Labs in the area. So he's also probably the one that took transistors into semiconductors.
嗯，好，所以这个 William Shockley, 哈，他是电晶体的创造者，哈， transistor 就是电晶体。好，那电晶体，那这个事实上电脑要靠基体电路，基体电路其实就是把很多的 transistor 把它缩小到一个很小的晶片里面去，这样子，哈。那所以他创造了这个电晶体，那他也是把这个电晶体呢创造出来之后成为了 the building block of electronic systems, 就是电晶体它是这个电路或者电子系统的 building block, 就是建构的元件，所以电子系统要靠这个电晶体把它这个建构起来。那这个人呢，他 founded, 主要动词在 founded, 他创立了这个 Shockley Semiconductor Labs, 就是这个半导体的实验室，在这个他在这个旧金山湾区，在1950年代创办的半导体实验室。
So I just said probably, but actually, it's actually true. They, meaning William Shockley's labs, were the first to use silicon in semiconductors. So they developed the original semiconductor. And that laid the foundation for a booming industry, which Taiwan is also a participant.
Yeah.好，那他们是 the first two, 他们是第一个使用矽这个东西啊，在这个半导体里面使用矽的啊这个人啊，他们也因为这样子，所以奠下了基础 ,laying the foundation for, 奠下什么基础呢？一个 booming industry, 一个蓬勃发展的工业的基础啊，所以台湾的这个啊，也因为半导体啊这的发展啊，台湾的经济受到很大的帮助。
So there's this journalist named Don Heffler, and he's the first guy to use the name Silicon Valley in the USA. And he did this in his 1971 report on the industry, and the name has stuck ever since. So he's the guy that coined the name Silicon Valley. And it's catchy. It's easy to translate into Chinese, and it sounds good.
Yeah, 所以这个记者，这位记者呢，他第一次在，首先在一个1971年的报告里面用到了这个 Silicon Valley in the USA 啊，这个词，那这个名字呢 has stuck 就是这个黏住了，就是一直用到现在啊，就好像黏住了那种感觉啊 ，fixed 啊，或者是 attached 啊，就已经黏住了，跟这个地方黏在一起的，从那个时候开始就一直用这个名字了。
Now the valley also owes its existence, the fact that it's there.And its prosperity, the fact that it's doing so well, to Stanford University.
那 owes something to, 就是这个 owe, 就是 be indebted to, 就是要归功于要谢某人的意思啊。所以这个矽谷呢，它的存在还有它的 prosperity, 它的繁荣也要归功于斯坦福大学。
And why is that? It's because Frederick Terman, He was the provost. He was the guy that ran things and also the dean of engineering. So he was also running the engineering school, but also he was the provost of the university. He was the guy in charge of the whole university. So he did something really important. He nurtured these tech firms by doing what? By leasing them land in the Stanford Industrial Park. He was like, okay, I got this piece of land. Let's say you guys can come in and build buildings, or maybe there's buildings already there. You guys can come there and put your stuff in, and we will support you. And he did this because he was smart and he wanted a place for his students to go. But also, I mean, that probably wasn't his only reason, but that was definitely one of his reasons. But by doing so, he created like another hub where people could communicate with each other and develop their ideas. So between the Navy being there, between William Shockley being there, between NASA being there, and then Stanford University having their Stanford Industrial Park, there's four important sources of funding and ideas, and that's so important when you're developing industry.
Yeah. 好, 所以我们看到这一句, 这个, Frederick Terman, 他是 Provost, 他是一个大学的高阶的行政首长。好，那在这里他可能是教务长，也可能是校长，不过我们这里把它翻成教务长。他是教务长，也是 Dean of Engineering， 也是这个工程学系的工程学院的院长。他怎么样呢？ Nurtured， Dean 是院长的意思。那 Nurtured 就是 to feed and protect 或者 to support 的意思。他这个等于说这个扶植可以翻成扶植这些科技公司。怎么样扶植呢？透过租借他们土地 leasing them land 在这个斯坦福的 industrial park 这个斯坦福的工业区里面租借土地给这些科技公司。
He also encouraged graduates and faculty to start their own companies. So he's like, you're a student, you're a teacher, just go start a company, try to make this happen. He was trying to make people really use what they were learning.And he didn't, you know, say, well, you're a teacher, you shouldn't participate in this, because he knows that that kind of interaction with teachers and students only makes things better. And so there was an example of William Hewlett and David Packard. And they went on to create Hewlett-Packard in 1939. And Hewlett-Packard has been such a force in the development of computers over time.
那他也鼓励 encouraged 这个 graduates, 就是大学毕业生但也有可能是研究生了所以他鼓励这些人呢还有他的 faculty 他的这个教授群来 start their own companies 让他们开创他们自己的公司例如说呢我们看到这 William Hewlett 还有这个 David Packard 他们两个人呢 went on to 就是他们继续下去所以一开始他们可能只是因为这个这一位校长的鼓励或教务长的鼓励但他们后来呢就继续往下做最后就创立了这个 Hewlett Packard 在1939年这个就是我们所谓知道的 HP
Yeah, and today the company is best known for like printers and computers and more but they've been one of the powerhouses of computer developments back when computers were the size of roomsHewlett Packard was like the brand to have. It was like top of the line. Anything you got computers-wise, if you got HP or Hewlett Packard, you're like, yep, you got quality. You spent the money on it.
所以今天呢，这个公司呢，它最有名的is best known for, 他们最有名的就是他们的电脑、他们的印表机，还有其他东西。那事实上这个 HP 他们在电脑的发展史上有很重要的地位。那尤其在以前的电脑很大的时候，那整个房间都是这个要放电脑的地方那个时候呢他们其实是很重要的品牌。
Now, Stanford was also one of the sites of a government research project, which would later become the global phenomenon we all know as the internet. So, at the time, it was called ARPANET, and it wasn't just a government research project. It was a Department of Defense project, which later turned into something that connected universities, and now it's something that connects everybody.
Yeah, 好，斯坦福呢，它也是这个一个地点，什么地点呢？是政府的一个研究计划。那事实上不只是政府，事实上美国军方的一个研究计划。那这个研究计划后来变成了全世界的一个 phenomenon, 一个全世界的现象。我们都知道的就是 the internet。
So with their impact on the Bay Area, it is little wonder that Terman and Shockley are called the fathers of Silicon Valley because it's with the infrastructure and the connections that they set up that laid the groundwork for the incredible development of Silicon Valley.
Yeah, 那 with 啊，这里可以翻成由于啊，由于他们对于这个 Bay Area 的 impact 影响啊，所以 it is little wonder that 这底下这件事情也没什么好奇怪的了哈、啊。什么事情没什么好奇怪的？就这两个人被称为戏骨之父啊，这也没什么好奇怪的，难怪他们被称为戏骨之父。
嗯。So that's all we have for today on this article, but join us again tomorrow to find out the future of Silicon Valley now that we've discussed the past. So we'll see you then.
Bye-bye.